Welcome to the United States Croquet Association 9-Wicket National Championships, August of 2023, being held in Denver in Pulaski Park. Call it 9-Wicket Backyard, Long Grass, what you will. Tournament director is Paul Bennet. And representing the Denver Croquet Club, Ron Eccles is the tournament manager, who along with friends and family did everything for this tournament. We are the official YouTube channel of the United States Croquet Association, which is dedicated to developing all versions of the game, including 9-Wicket. And now we're very proud to have the sponsorship of Don Oakley, who's been involved in development of croquet in North America for decades. His croquet store can supply all the equipment needs of developing clubs and beginning players, and when you've played for a while, he can provide you with the mallets that national and world champions have used. This tournament is under the auspices of the Denver Croquet Club, basically Ron Eccles. Where they usually play the short grass versions of the game is on this lawn bowling pitch in Washington Park. And the lawn bowlers were out in force the day I was there. And now back to Pulaski Park for another first flight game in the 9-Wicket Nationals. This one features Lance Titus, who's a Colorado local from Denver, I think. And he's playing in his first tournament. And acting like he knows what he's doing. Blue bounced off, I think red bounced off. They're playing the option where nobody's in the game until they make hoop two, so there are no roquets or continuation shots. And that's the case in both first flight and doubles and championship singles. His opponent is Dalton Major, who with his dad drove all night Tuesday night to barely get here in time to start on Wednesday, I think because of Dalton's academic obligations. He and his father have both played a lot of 9-Wicket. I'm not sure about their tournament experience, but they've both done this a lot. Because both in first flight singles and in doubles, they're not using carryover deadness. The board will just show clip positions, and later on, and when it gets complicated, we'll add in a column for points. The grass overall in the park is about as long as it can get and still be playable. This lawn actually is not too bad in a lot of places, but in course one and two, where we'll do the semifinals and finals tomorrow, it's challenging. Now, in American rules, you would just rush yellow over to hoop four, but that's very hard to do in these conditions. So you do a roquet and then a croquet shot that sends both balls over to the hoop in question and then set up yellow to make hoop four off of red. And red doesn't have to pay the penalty of getting dead by doing this. This cut is so aggressive, he could easily have missed it altogether. Well done. And that was way harder than he made it look. Dalton and his dad both do this a lot. They'll do a roquet and then use that opportunity to position the balls to give the object ball a perfect rush to its hoop on the next turn. And then they'll pass. Again, something you can only do if there's no carryover deadness. And only if the opponent's not in a position to attack. It's hard to tell here, but it looks like he's making hoop one and hoop two in the same stroke. And in all levels of competition in this tournament, you get two continuation shots if you make any two hoops in a row, or if you make hoop seven and the turning stake in one shot. And I suppose if you make the turning stake in hoop eight in one shot, like that's going to happen. Looked like Lance didn't realize he had another shot, and Dalton just waited. When I played my first tournament at the NCC low these many years ago, I did exactly what Lance is doing. I stayed on the lawn and hovered around the action, and boy, did I get yelled at. He's going to have to learn to get off the court when it's not his turn. He's rush peeling black through its hoop three, which makes him responsible for the correct placement of black clip. He doesn't mind giving black that hoop because he's setting up a three ball break for red. And on the scoreboard, OP means opponent peel. PP will mean partner peel. That ball didn't go out, but it needed to be marked in first flight in doubles, 36 inches, in championship flight, 9 inches. All you nine wicket players are quite familiar with what happens to the striker ball after a roquet. You can play it from where it lies, up to 9 inches away from the object ball or from in contact with the object ball. After one of these roquets, pretty soon Lance is going to have to attack instead of just focus on making hoops. Because he's going to find out that if he doesn't do it, Dalton will. Johnny Osborne, our number one American Rules icon and mentor, likes to say that if you're ahead, you really don't have to attack. That doesn't hold Dalton back. The general rule in American Rules on short grass is in a attack mode like this, you would roquet first the ball you want to leave behind, which would be black. But that's to get a rush on the other ball, and he can't really use a rush on the other ball, so he just goes first for the ball that his partner needs. So red sends blue back to yellow. I would expect him to shoot it blue, put it up by hoop 7, and then make 6 off red and get the full turnaround going. But he's going to take the hoop shot first. Like to have that one back. He's correctly leaving red the danger ball in an awkward position. And I thought he was going to send yellow to black. But he's just getting rid of it, which it would work better had he given yellow to black so the black would have a 3-ball break.
By the way, we're not going to be setting up that fencing and signage tomorrow.
Okay.
So do you need any promo shots for that stuff?
Can we leave it up till this game is?
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
I'm definitely not pulling it down. That'll be the last stuff that we pulled out anyway.
Okay.
So you can take any promo you want. But I'm saying definitely do it tonight because it won't be there tomorrow.
Okay, good.
Dalton moves red about a ball diameter. Black to play. He may be a rookie tournament player, but he's catching up, and he's doing it with peels, one from Dalton and two of his own. Gauging the terrain is an important part of this game. He's taking advantage of that low area where the water has kept the grass from growing to make shots like that possible. He went to get black, brought it back. Let's see how far he can get with this. You cannot start to score a hoop by placing the striker ball in hand against a ball that is beyond the plane of the non-playing side. So if red has scored that hoop, he can't score that hoop with yellow from this position. He has to find a way to get back around in front of the hoop to do that. Or I've seen Rick Sheely, albeit with thicker, heavier stanchions, put yellow in that position, and then in the croquet shot, the same time that you move red a little bit, bounce yellow off the stanchions into hoop shooting position, then you have to make the hoop because you're dead on red and it's going to be sitting just beyond the hoop. Of course, this is 9 wicket, so he could put yellow back 9 inches and jump over red to make the hoop, and it wouldn't matter if he hit it on the way as long as he made the hoop. See, he actually handles this pretty well. He needs to get red out of there. But he has an escape ball sitting next to the turning stake. And he realizes that yellow has not scored hoop 7. Some clarification ensues. It was almost perfect. He's going to learn to resist this urge to get rid of the spent ball. Would have been better to put blue on the other side. Give yellow the hoop, but give yellow to black, then get rid of red and leave blue by hoop six and black the opportunity to make four hoops in the turning stake. You're supposed to do this visually or with a $100 bill, not with your mallet. You'll move the ball and mess everything up. And these wire wickets are easy to move, too. He clearly made 8 and 9 in one shot. But he doesn't take two continuation shots. I don't know why. And it's an Irish peel. And he's never played a tournament before. Dalton's far enough ahead that attacking might seem overly aggressive here. But 9 wicket has something that the other two traditional versions of the game don't. It's this grouping of two hoops and a turning stake. If your two balls are set up and both for hoop 6, it's an opportunity to score 10 points in 2 turns. So even if the opponent is ahead, attacking makes sense. If you play a lot of American rules, you might think that leaving blue there runs the risk of giving it a wiring lift. But they don't use a wiring rule in 9 wicket. You've all heard the stories of the British team taking on the Americans in the late 70s, in the very early days of American rules. and realizing that there was no wiring rule in the book at that time. They just spent the whole tournament stuffing opponent balls and hoops, so they had no shots. The rule book was changed the following week, or so I've heard. I'm sure Johnny Osborne knows exactly how it happened. Here he overrolled Yellow's hoop, so he's going to go to Red's hoop but one. Interesting. But balls in hoops are not great pioneers.
It's going to be another little while in this game. If you want to video your entryway with your phone, it'll work perfectly well. Yeah.
Well, that's why Ron sent me over to ask me if you had done that.
Go do it with a phone, and that way I can finish this game, and the phone will be perfectly good. Do something artistic about the entry and wax eloquent, and then I'll use it.
Wax eloquent? Say something? All
right,
I will video something.
Figure
I don't know
out.
What I have to say.
You can do it.
This event was very much a group
Ron's
affair.
Ron's going to do it, I think, actually.
Well, he sent me over to ask him.
I was just talking to him on the phone. Is what...
Oh, okay.
Steve, you want to grab him?
So, black's dead on blue. And in this game, just like AC, there's no rule against hitting a ball you're dead on. You just don't get another shot. So those balls should stay right where they are. They're misinterpreting the rule here. Lance is getting a little discouraged here. He forgets that he has the continuation shot. Dalton reminds him of it. Here comes another peel. It looks like an Irish peel, but it's not because that wasn't Yellow's hoop. Lots of peels in this game, and why, you might ask, that they call it a peel? It's because it was a favorite tactic in the late 19th century of Walter Peel. Most don't know that he also basically founded the governing body of croquet in England in 1896. And it was renamed the Croquet Association in 1900 and has remained so ever since. This unique grouping of hoops and stake in 9 wicket for Lance has become the Bermuda Triangle instead of a scoring opportunity. Clarifying that he gets 2 strokes now because he made hoop 7 and hit the tourney stake in 1 stroke. And why he didn't just set up for 8 and then hit it with a short shot, I don't know. And the black clip should be on 9. Blue did not make hoop 8, and its clip is appropriately placed. So he's reverting to first tournament jitters. Dalton must not be watching. But this is how they're going to play it. So we'll make blue for hoop 10. Black is still for 9. If ever there were a time to attack, it is now. Okay, maybe now. But the attack should be now when you have two shots. Not after you've tried to position partner in front of its hoop. He'll get there. And Lance, when you watch this, don't feel bad. You'll be amazed at how many people will be grateful for what they've learned from watching this game. I don't know where they are with the clock, but they must be close. I think they're using the sudden stop rule where when time runs out, the game's over. And if it's tied, whichever ball is closest to its next hoop gets that point and thus wins the game. But that would be the only reason for Lance to get out of bounds at this point. This next may be an example of cognitive dissonance. Let's stop it and figure out how he wins. He's down by 6 hoops. So he should turn around, roquet blue, put blue on the other side of 10, make 10. Then roquet blue, go to yellow, use that to get to red on the boundary, send red back to blue, and then let blue make the final 6 hoops he needs to win. But his urge to score this hoop is overwhelming. Now he only has an impossible long shot on yellow. But frankly, he came closer than I thought he would. Dalton's an experienced player. Lance is definitely going to get there. So Dalton wins in block by 6. So there is more coming from the 9-wicket Nationals in Denver. Be sure to give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. And thanks again to our sponsors, the USCA and Don Oakley and the Croquet Store, where you can get everything you need for whatever level of croquet you aspire to. Be it 9-wicket in your backyard or a world championship in hurling them.